मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विथ आवर टेक्स्ट बुक, इंग्लिश टेक्स्ट बुक. फर्स्ट पोएम वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न, पास्ट प्रेजेंट फ्यूचर, अ वेरी एक्साइटिंग पोएम. नाउ अबाउट पास्ट प्रेजेंट फ्यूचर, वी आर नोइंग एवरीबडी वी आर हैविंग पास्ट, वी आर लिविंग इन द प्रेजेंट. And tomorrow is our future that we don't know what is going to happen. So yesterday is history, tomorrow is a mystery, and today is a gift of God, which is why we call it is the present. So life can only be understood backwards, but it must be lived forwards. So now on the screen you can see the cover page of English Bal Bharati Standard 7 textbook. Now here, what you are observing here on the cover page, that is the blue mormon is our state butterfly. You can see this butterfly name is blue mormon, and it is our state butterfly. And the cover shows blue mormons enjoying nectar from books which have blossomed on the plants. So we are knowing that butterflies enjoying the nectars. So but these state butterflies, these are enjoying books, nectar from books. So they also means the exactly cover page wants to tell us that we should study. Yes, so we are going to see unit 1.1, past, present, future. Before that, this poem is written by Emily Bronte. So about Emily Bronte, I want to say something. Emily Bronte and her sisters were well-known authors who lived in 19th century. And Emily Bronte uses nature to talk about her thoughts, feelings and ideas in many of her poems. And this poem about time is presented in the form of a dialogue between the poet and a happy child. So for the child in the poem, the past was like a pleasant time, but sadly we cannot go back to it. And the present time, present is a time when you prepare for the future, which is unknown but exciting. So now what Emily Bronte and a happy child, we are seeing the poem past, present, future. Now I will recite poem for you and then I will explain the meaning. Tell me, smiling child, what the past is like to thee. An autumn evening soft and mild, with a wind it sighs mournfully. Tell me, what is the present hour, a green and flowery spray, where young bird sits gathering its power to mount and fly away. And what is the future, happy one, a sea beneath a cloudless sun, a mighty, glorious, dazzling sea stretching into infinity. Emily Bronte. Now we are going to see the first stanza of the poem. Tell me, smiling child, what the past is like to thee. An autumn evening soft and mild, with a wind that sighs mournfully. Now here the poet asks the child, who is smiling? What is the past is like to the child? And what the child is replying, that past is like autumn evening, soft and mild, with a wind that sighs sadly. Now the child is telling about autumn evening. Now we are knowing that autumn is the season between summer and winter, and when the weather becomes cool and the leaves of the trees fallen down. Now, while India does not have summer winter season, now why we don't have the autumn and spring seasons here? Because seasons are caused due to tilt of the earth's axis. We have studied in the geography and the earth's revolution around the sun towards the months of May, June and the northern hemisphere and pointing towards the sun, winters and summers. So we don't have the autumn season in India. So what autumn is saying that? Autumn is saying that leaves are fallen and now the next new is going to start. So this is about first stanza, and here you can see the second line D. That means meaning is you, that is old English. Then you can see the in the third line word mild, that means not severe or very cold. It means very cold, normal weather. And in the last line you can see the mournfully, that means very sadly. You can note down these meanings in your notebook. Now second stanza we are going to see. Tell me what is the present hour, a green and flowery spray, where a young bird sits gathering its power to mount and fly away. Now what here the poet asks the child her or his opinion of the present situation, and what the child replies, the present is like green branch of flowers of which a young bird sits and gathering the strength to fly away. We are knowing the young ones, how it tries to learn the flying. He first gathering the power, and slowly from the branch he tries to spread his wings and fly in the sky. So this is what about the young bird, present situation. So now here also you can see in the second line spray, it means a stem or a small branch of tree or a plant, and that is bearing flowers. And in the last line you can see to mount, that means to get up. Birds tries to get up. Next, third stanza. And what is the future happy one? A sea beneath a cloudless sun. A mighty, glorious, dazzling sea stretching into infinity. That means the poet asks the happy child about the future. Now for this, what child is replying? That future is like sea, that is beneath the sun in a cloudless sky. We are knowing that sea is very powerful, glorious and shining brightly, and it stretches on without an end. So you can see in the picture or in the textbook that how that girl lies on the land and she's observing the sky and she's very happy. She don't have any tension, anything, and she's glorious, glorious, happy, and she is watching to the sky. In the second slide you have seen the bird, young bird, and in the first slide you have seen the autumn season. Now here homework is given, that page number 2 यू हैव टू सॉल्व द एक्सरसाइज 2 to 5 एंड हियर लैंग्वेज स्टडी 6. हियर सम ग्रामर इज गिवन दैट आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू दैट a simile इज एन दिस इज अ पार्ट ऑफ स्पीच एंड सिमिली इज एन सॉरी इट इज अ फिगर ऑफ स्पीच. अ simile इज एन इमेजिनेटिव कंपेरिजन ऑफ टू डिफरेंट थिंग्स विच हैव समथिंग इन कॉमन एंड अ simile ऑलवेज इंक्लूड्स द वर्ड्स हैज और लाइक. फॉर एग्जाम्पल एज टॉल एज ट्री एज लवली एज अ फ्लावर. मोर एग्जाम्पल वी कैन गिव दैट इज हर स्माइल इज एज ब्राइट एज द सन. हियर टू थिंग्स आर कंपेयर्ड गर्ल एंड सन. हर स्माइल इज ब्राइट लाइक द सन. सो हियर अ कंपेरिजन बिटवीन टू थिंग्स एंड वी हैव टू यूज एज और लाइक. नेक्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू सी दैट इज मेटाफर्स. A metaphor is an imaginative expression that refers to someone or something as another person or thing, and it shows that the person or thing has some quality of that other person or thing. The words as or like are not used in a metaphor. For example, he is a gem of a person, or time is money. Books are our friends. The clouds are white sheep. What other example we can give, like my brother is a cute little teddy bear. Right? This is metaphor, that means imaginative expression. Like brother how he compared like a cute teddy bear. Right? So here in this poem there are 3 metaphors, so you have to find that also. So already I have given the homework, that is solve question number 2 to 6 in your English notebook, right? So today what we have learned, that life is a learning experience. All you can do is learn from your mistakes, but you can't go back in the time because time moves. This is what about past. About present, Mother Teresa, we are knowing Mother Teresa. She rightly said that yesterday is gone. Tomorrow has not yet come. We have only today. So let us begin. So this is what about our present situation, right? And about the future is no more uncertain than the present. Present today that we are living today, that we are knowing, but our future is uncertain. So I hope you have enjoyed the poem. So recite the poem twice and do the homework. Thank you, children.